Hey there everybody, Matt Carter here.
And Jessica Carter from CarterMatt.com.
This video is our first viewing reaction for The Expanse Season 2, Episode 7, fittingly entitled The Seventh Man.
Yep.
I feel like if this was Episode 8, maybe they would have had to come up with one more character so it could have been The Eighth Man. You gotta keep the continuity, people.
That's right.
Alright, so we have in this episode the aftermath of what happens to Bobby Draper. Yep. We have everything that is going down with the who wants to be in charge of the belt debate.
Yeah.
As it turns out, the belt's version of an election is rather interesting.
Yes, it is.
We've got candidates. We've got a stolen courtesan. Lots of interesting stuff going down here. But before we do anything else, if you like this video, be sure to give us a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any other updates we have coming your way. Alright, so I feel like this episode is sort of like we're kind of getting past Miller's death. Not that we're past it, but the show is trying to get past it.
And I'm not past it.
Yeah.
Yes, the show is trying to get past it, but you cannot take him out of my heart.
No. Miller will always be there, but I think the Expanse in this episode really tries to push things forward. I mean, the protomolecule, it's still a point of discussion, but it feels like right now there are other big-time issues at play, and I think we have to talk about the title mystery here first. Who is the Seventh Man?
Yeah, and it's an interesting question we have no answers to right now. The only thing that I feel about the Seventh Man is that they got something to do with this protomolecule. I don't know if this is an alien. I don't know if this is the protomolecule has turned itself into a person again. I don't know what is going on at this point, but it feels like it's got to be connected with how everything just got decimated.
I'm sticking with my theory from episode 6, and that is the protomolecule sort of like summoned whoever this alien is. Almost as though it collected some sort of summoning spell or materia for all of you Final Fantasy VII fans. There we go.
Is that because we were just talking about that earlier?
Possibly.
Yeah.
So, you know, the protomolecule, that was the summon spell that was cast by this alien. And that summon spell, pointed out where the alien could go. I don't know what the end game is here with any of this, though. That's the real sort of mystery.
Because we're not supposed to know at this point. Even though they've tied up what's happened with Miller, the mystery is growing.
Yeah, and we know that there is alien life out there in the form of this protomolecule, but it doesn't really seem like humanity was making that much of an active threat to any other sort of civilization. It doesn't seem like they had that level of technology yet.
No, but that doesn't mean that these alien life forms don't want to know what's going on over here and what they could maybe get from those people. Maybe they want to be the only people or the only aliens in the universe. Whatever they're doing, they seem to be wanting to start a war.
Yes, I think that is clear, and I think they're trying on some level to use all of this chaos that's going on Earth versus Mars to sort of accelerate things further. This episode got me closer to feeling for Bobby Draper than any other one so far, at least from the vantage point that, she's almost dead. Everyone she knows has been killed. She's now also being forced to accept, this ideology that she doesn't even believe is true.
I hate to say that I am still on the fence about Bobby, but I am. And it took me a little while to not be on the fence about Holden, but I got there with him.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that I am going to get there with Bobby. I definitely felt for her where basically everything that she was brought up to believe and trained to believe as being part of the Martian army, now all of a sudden it's, you're gonna lie. You're gonna go to Earth and you're gonna lie because you're going to stop a war from happening. And at the very least, it seems that both Mars and Earth want to try to find a way to have some sort of peace. At least that's what I'm getting from this. That they don't really necessarily know everything yet, that they both really want this. But it seems like that's what the goal is by having Bobby go down there. And basically, like, yeah, we did it. We take responsibility, and we're sorry.
And I mean, I think in general, most people tend to want peace. I mean, unless you are somebody who's like profiting off of war, or somebody who just hates the other side like so extremely that you're willing to risk your own life, I think.
Or someone or a group of people like the Belters that maybe are disenfranchised and aren't really part of this, even though they clearly should be. You've got Earth, you've got Mars, and then this group of people that's just kind of screwed in the middle.
Well, this is where the mystery of the seventh man comes into play. Because what do we know about the seventh man is that they were there at the site of the battle. They were there firing some stuff off.
Yep.
And they were not wearing a space suit.
Yeah.
What does that mean? Okay, so here are the possibilities I've thought about.
Okay.
Number one, aliens.
Yes.
Number two, superpowers.
Oh my God.
Number three, someone has been
not
like
superpowers.
Well, you never know. Anything else could happen in this. But number three, someone going down in a blaze of glory who knew that they were gonna die in like 2 seconds later, and they were just like, it's like when we're playing Borderlands and like I know that I'm gonna die and I run in anyway and get killed in like 3 seconds.
Blaze of glory?
Yeah. Maybe this is a blaze of glory situation.
I'm going to have to go and disagree with the Blaze of Glory. I feel like Alien is probably the way that it's going, and that for whatever reason, they're either they don't breathe or they can breathe that atmosphere or something. But yeah, it's a story that Bobby's going to have a hard time convincing anybody of. She was really stuck on that there was a drone, so maybe there was a recording that somebody was going to be able to, you know, corroborate her story that this happened, because everyone that was there is dead. So it's just her and what she's remembered. And now people are telling her to not remember that. That didn't happen. Get that out of your head and let's all move on. Why? This seems like this is really important information that Mars would want to know.
Yeah, it feels that way.
Yeah.
And I think there's all sorts of curious motivations and questions to wonder about that.
Yeah, it's probably just a situation where they want Bobby to stop the war from coming, but that they're going to take Bobby's information and they're going to figure it out in secret.
I think that's probably where they would want to go. They want to have control over everything. They want to control the narrative. They want to control the situation. I guess I thought of another four possibility for this.
Besides Blaze of Glory and superpowers?
Yeah, this one's maybe a little more plausible.
All right, let's
maybe
have
someone
it.
Has come up with some sort of technology that they've allowed themselves. It's not so much that they have the ability to breathe in that condition, but maybe they've developed some sort of either helmet of invisibility that you put on, or some sort of device that actually just pumps oxygen and everything else you need through some other part of your body without breathing it in, and maybe that's how they're able to make it.
Like some sort of like jet through your skin
or
something like that?
Anything's possible. Yeah.
Anything's possible, but we do have stealth ships. Is it possible that there was some sort of stealth spacesuit?
Maybe.
I'm not leaning in that direction, but it's possible.
I feel like aliens is like 80% chance, and then there's maybe like I think superheroes are probably 0.001%.
Oh, you're giving it that high.
Yeah, why not? But no, I think whatever it's going to be, it's a good mystery for the show to have right now, because it's sort of like, you went through everything with Julie Mao. You're dealing with the emotional stuff with Miller.
Yep.
And yet, they've still given you something almost immediately to sink your teeth into. So there's not like any sort of dead period.
No. And we've got the protomolecule is still in play. Naomi decided not to send it. Now it's coming back to bite everybody in the you-know-where.
Yeah. I feel like Naomi's been pretty solid when it comes to her thinking a lot of the time.
Yeah, I was always, the more that I've been like thinking about that scene with her and Holden where she's running those tests and he's like, you know, is it ready? We're ready. We're going to do this sort of thing. Yeah, we're going to do it. And it just felt like it was something she was on board with, but something in that moment just, it felt like it just changed for her and it was there.
Yeah.
That it was sort of in that moment, the way that Holden was kind of just talking about it or talking to her about it, there was something that felt in that conversation that she made the decision at that moment to not do it and that she was prepared.
I think there's got to be something in Naomi's past that we don't fully recognize just yet.
I also kind of wonder if it's just between... I understand that Holden and Naomi are together and, yeah. and they're sleeping together and that there is a connection with them on some sort of romantic level, respect level. But there is also something else going on there, whether it's Holden being an Earther and not really fully understanding what it's like to be a Belter, what they've gone through, and Naomi feeling maybe a bit put off by some of the things that he's saying, because he's, I don't necessarily think he's trying to be rude about Belters, but at the same time, some of the things he's saying can come across that way, and I could see rubbing her the wrong way, or some of the way that she feels about Belters rubbing him the wrong way. I'm kind of interested to see what that little bit of a divide is going to do for these two.
There's a little bit of a, I don't want to say a white knight, but there's a little bit of something in Holden where he think maybe this is his version of a savior complex, where he almost, way back when, before he became the person he is now, and we heard about his backstory via his mother, that, you know, moving away from these responsibilities and this burden, it seems like now he's embracing things, but he's also embracing things that are not even fully his, like that speech that he gave, you know, at Tycho, where it's starting to feel like, okay, here is Holden trying to speak about the best interest of the Belters, and Holden's not a Belter, he's just putting his foot in a pond that he doesn't fully belong in. And neither
really is Fred. That was what was kind of interesting about it. Yeah, he's the head of the OPA, but he's also an Earther who is now with the Belters. That's fine, but Holden is brand new to all of this, and we've heard him kind of spout off about Belters in private, so we kind of know
he's got some issues.
He's got some issues, but I understand why he spoke up. He was there. He saw what happened with the protein molecule. It makes sense for him to be there, but I don't know if he should have spoken up.
Yeah, it's a complicated situation because I think knowledge is power, and he feels like the knowledge gives him power, and it does, but it doesn't necessarily give him social capital. It doesn't really give him the ability to speak or understand or relate to these people. He can be a hero in a different way, but he feels like he would be better suited as a liaison to the problem rather than a spokesperson.
Yeah, the person I was actually surprised that didn't speak up was Naomi.
Yeah.
Because this is her crew, at, like, with the Rossi, but this is also her crew of where she relates to and Belters and where, you know, her whole heart is. So, and she was there, and she saw all this happen. I was a little bit surprised that she was as reserved as she was, but here we are.
Here we are, about to start a new game entitled, Who Wants to Lead the Belters? Let's look at all of the candidates. You have
The Butcher!
You have Fred Johnson, a man named The Butcher.
Who also stole the Naboo, and everybody's mad at him.
Not exactly a good time for... I love that they're basically just, like, overtly foreshadowing Fred's death like I did already in these videos.
Yeah.
Maybe, ironically, he won't die, and that's sort of the twist at all of this.
Yeah,
but
maybe. I just... There's not a lot of scenarios I see Fred coming out of the show alive, but
No. Fred's in a bad way at the moment. Then we have, just when you thought we were gone with Ceres forever, Anderson Dawes just kicks open the door and is like,
I am here.
I am Jared Harris. I am going to dominate this entire episode with my awesomeness. It's like, I want to say that Anderson Dawes is my guy, but Anderson Dawes is also a bad dude. It's also just kind of like, I like having Anderson on the show. And he probably is good to a certain degree of certain group of people, but it's sort of like...
Yeah, but he is just so manipulative. Yeah. He is able to talk anybody into anything. I like when Naomi was giving that speech about how he takes a tax, which is really just a shakedown, that he gives it back. I mean, does he? I don't know. It doesn't really feel like it, but it feels like everybody believes it. And that whole scene with Diogo, you know, he's young, he's impressionable. He just went through it with Miller. He was there. He was there to blow it up. He knew how dangerous this stuff was. And now all of a sudden, here he is, based on a few words from someone who is as charismatic and strong and empowering as Anderson Dawes, that he could take someone like Diogo, who has seen it, and still convince him that this is a good idea.
Yeah.
Bring me to this thing that killed all these people that you almost died for, because if Miller hadn't taken that bomb from him and put his finger on it, Diogo would be no more.
Yeah. No, Diogo would be gone. And now Diogo is helping out Anderson Dawes, who seems to also have Cortazar now, and they are...
So bad. This situation is so bad.
Yeah, this situation is really, really not good. It does speak to how, you know, persuasive Anderson Dawes can be. And, you know, he is...
Charisma goes a long way.
Yeah, and I think Fred tried to give him Fred probably set this up in a bad way as well, because I think Fred was trying to be like, oh, you know, he controls a lot of stuff at Ceres. Or just because someone controls a lot of stuff and has a lot of respect for a certain group of people, that does not mean that they are a good leader to a point, because we know how Anderson Dawes deals with violence. It's not often with diplomacy.
No, it's not.
No, so I think...
And we do not need him, of all the people, to have the protomolecule in his hands. It feels like this is going to be so bad.
You know, though, I will say this. If they can stop Anderson Dawes, bring him back to Tycho, if you give me just like a 42-minute episode of just Jared Harris and Chad Coleman in a room yelling at each other, it will basically be the greatest episode of my entire life.
On the other hand, if Anderson Dawes gets this protomolecule and he's actually able to use it as some sort of a bargaining chip to actually bring the belt into its own, where it's its own serious player, so it will be equality between Earth, Mars, and Belters. It's going to be very interesting to see that play out. Like, I don't necessarily think that he's going to go and take this and be like, all right, Mars and Earth, you guys want to die, or you guys want to give us, you know, what we're asking for? He might play it that way, but he just the threat that he's got, it might be enough to put him on the table and put the Belters on the table.
That's why I love Anderson Dawes so much. And it's just because he will be seen by some people, if all that happens, as a unifier, that he's brought the belt together, he's got him a seat at the table, but then he is also just like brutal and heartless individual in a lot of ways, who can do just horrible things.
Yeah, and just really anybody having this protomolecule, like, I still am not understanding Naomi's decision on this. I've tried to come up with some theories in my head of why she did this and what it was that she needed inside of her to have a little bit of control over the situation. What was it? Leave me your comments below. Tell me what you think of why she made this decision. Because for me, she was there. She saw it. She saw so many people die. Miller is dead. Like, Julie is dead. 150,000 people, Belters, are dead. So if you know that this is a thing that causes such destruction, you know that anybody who gets their hands on it, whether it's Anderson, whether it's Fred, whether it's Earth, whether it's Mars, anybody at any point could turn this thing into something that is just going to wipe everybody out.
Yeah, it's...
And let's not even talk about your theory that it's like a beacon and it's calling in the seventh man and whoever's coming along with that mess.
That could be a mess. And it
was surprising that she made that decision.
Well.
But it did feel like it was a decision she made at that moment. It didn't feel like she was getting ready to do it. And then, but she had thought already, oh, I'm never going to. I'm just going to pretend like I'm going to. But it felt like it was whatever was in that conversation with Holden, something triggered inside of her to be like, I'm not doing this.
Yeah, well, with that in mind, as we wrap this video up, give us your theories on that, but also give us your thoughts as you watched this episode for the first time, what were you thinking about Draper? What were you thinking about the Seventh Man? All this good stuff. And if you enjoy this video, be sure to give us a like, subscribe, and you can support us more by checking that link in the description to the Carter Matt store. And we'll see you here next time.